Hello, welcome. Thank you all so much for joining me here. My name is Charity, and this message is for Virgo. So this is going to be a you and them love reading. I'll have your cards on one side and your person's cards on the other. This is someone you are connected to energetically, romantically, someone that you are thinking about, and someone who is thinking about you. I'm recording this message for the energies of June, but I do ask these readings to be timeless and give you something you need to hear when you need to hear it. So for your cards, Virgo, I'll be using the Mystical Manga Tarot. For your person, the traditional Rider-Waite. And if clarifiers are needed, the Fortune Telling Tarot Deck by Yoshitaka Amano. So let's get started. Spirit, what is the heart of the matter? What is Virgo thinking overall right now about a connection or potential connection? What are some things going on in the daily life could be affecting this connection? What is happening in your heart space? How are you feeling? How are you feeling about your person? What intentions do you have towards this connection? And what is a potential outcome in the near future whenever you are meant to hear this message? Let's get the cards for your person. Spirit, what is the heart of the matter for the person connected to or coming towards Virgo? What are they thinking right now? What are some things going on in the daily life could be affecting the connection? What is happening in their heart space? How are they feeling? How are they feeling about Virgo? How are they feeling about Virgo? What intentions do they have towards this connection? And what is a potential outcome in the near future for whenever you are meant to hear this message? Okay, wow, we got some pretty intense cards going on here. I have to say that the final cards look really good. Like, it looks like something is definitely coming together, but you might not even have any idea right now. The bottom of the deck for your person, we have a Ten of Swords. For you, for the heart of the matter, we have a Ten of Swords. I mean, that is pretty intense energy there. Like, you, this person might be feeling defeated. They might not know if you're interested. The two of you might not even be talking right now. Something could have ended. Something could have gone quiet. But I feel like whatever the situation is, the two of you are thinking about each other quite a lot, and maybe even more than you realize. So, heart of the matter for you, we do have the Ten of Swords. Something could have ended. You might be kind of over and done thinking about something. If something has been stressing you out, this is the end of a painful cycle. So it really is reaching the end, but it is getting to a point where it's like you just don't even know if something is going to be going on or if you can let it go on. Let's see what this is all about. Spirit, why do we have this Ten of Swords for the heart of the matter for Virgo? Why do we have this Ten of Swords? We got the Four of Wands and the High Priestess. It's almost as if you're really interested in somebody and you might not even be talking about it. Gemini energy for that Ten of Swords, Aries for the Four of Wands, Virgo, Pisces, Cancer for me for that High Priestess energy. But with the Four of Wands, Virgo, there might be somebody that you're thinking about, somebody you might even like to take things to the next level with, explore. But for some reason, it almost feels like a no contact situation. Obviously, it's not going to be the case for everyone watching these videos, and different things will come up, I'm sure, throughout the reading, but there's a lot of quiet energy here. Even though there is this quiet energy, I do feel like you could be thinking very deeply about somebody, and you could even be thinking about what it might be like to move forward and, you know, really take this to the next level. But you also might not even be sure, you know, if it's over or if it could go forward. Your person has Eight of Swords. Gemini energy, again, could be significant. For some reason, this person is feeling kind of stuck. Like, they don't know if they should take, you know, take a chance, say something, do something, if they even could. They don't even know, maybe, if you even want to hear from them or talk to them with this energy here. Now, with the Eight of Swords, it is somebody going around in circles in their mind, feeling stuck. But the only place forever really stuck is in our mind. The swords are mental energy. This person is free to kind of shrug out of this tie, kind of shrug out of these, you know, bindings here and walk free of this overthinking kind of situation, but they don't know. I mean, honestly, somebody might not have any idea either. Like, if you're interested, if you want to talk to them, if you want to hear from them, but I feel like they can't get you off their mind, honestly. Spirit, why do we have the Eight of Swords? Why do we have the Eight of Swords for what this person could be thinking about Virgo right now? Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, look at this. I mean, the Ace of Pentacles and the Four of Wands. And see if we can get an image for that Four of Wands so we can kind of look at what is going on here. There's definitely this sense, and yeah, I'm gonna get both of the traditional images just so I could show you because it popped into my mind the second, you know, I saw that pop up, and I feel like this is kind of what's going on here. Okay, now, if I got the Four of Wands and the Ace of Pentacles in a reading, like a personal reading, if somebody was going to ask, are we going to take this to the next level? Are we going to get engaged? Are we going to get serious? I would absolutely say yes. And these are the energies that the two of you have here, facing right towards, you know, one another. They've got this Ace of Pentacles here. You've got this Four of Wands. It's like both of you are interested. So it's a little confusing that you're feeling kind of defeated here and that it might be over, not saying a word maybe with this High Priestess energy, even though you are picking up. I mean, I think you are picking up on each other's energy like crazy. This person has an Eight of Swords wanting, you know, to do something with this Ace of Pentacles. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy could be significant, but feeling like they don't even know. If they were to reach out, if they were to say something, if they were to make an offer, like, would you answer? Would you be interested? They honestly have really no idea, at least in this energy. Now, this all feels very specific. So, you know, of course, not everybody is going to be in this exact same situation. So take it how it resonates for you. But your both of you, your daily life energies are beautiful. You have major arcana. For you, you've got the Wheel of Fortune, strong Sagittarius energy for me as a reader because it's Jupiter, it's movement, it's change, it's abundance, it's transformation. And a lot of people get the fixed energies, Taurus, Scorpio, Aquarius, Leo could be significant, and Aries and Aquarius for me with the Fool here. But Virgo, with the Wheel of Fortune, I feel like regardless of what has ever gone on to cause some sort of miscommunication, some sort of quiet, you're interested. You like this person. You want to talk to them. You want to move forward. You do want to see something happen. But it's almost, in a sense, almost like you might be waiting for the universe to kind of spin the wheel, just waiting for the universe to make something happen. And you will just go. Like, you want this to move forward, but it's almost like you're wanting something to just happen naturally. Spirit, why do we have the Wheel of Fortune for Virgo in the daily life here? Why do we have the Wheel of Fortune? That Judgment and the Queen of Swords, Libra energy, Virgo, I'm sorry, Aquarius. Of course, we have Virgo here because that's your energy. Libra, Aquarius, and Gemini could be significant. Strong Libra because Queens are cardinal. But there's something here, Virgo, with this Judgment card and this Queen of Swords that it's like you know in your mind, almost like crystal clear, what it is you want, what it is you're hoping will happen. You could be thinking about somebody like crazy, but there's all this mental energy and there's all this powerful, like universal energy. But what I don't see is you like taking that step or this person, you know, really just saying what needs to be said here. But with the Judgment card and the Wheel of Fortune, this is like the universe intervening. This is your universe coming in and shifting gears, changing things. It's a turning point, and it's something that is just bound to happen. And it wouldn't be coming into your life, into your experience, if you weren't asking for it. It is a very positive change. With the Judgment card, this is like the past is in the past. This can be bringing something out in the open. It can be having a conversation with someone. It can be just deciding, you know what? Let's just forget about the past. Let's see what can happen. Let's see where this can go. And I do feel like, you know, there's some divine intervention here, but it's something that you're wanting, because the Queen of Swords is all about setting intentions, being crystal clear, you know, fighting for what it is you want, clearing, releasing things that you don't want, you know, being really sure in your mind how you feel, what's important. Just one second. Let me tell my dog to be quiet. Hey, shh. It's not anywhere near dinner time, and he's pacing around behind me like I forgot about him, but I did not. He's a really smart old dog, and he knows when I sit down to do readings, I'll be busy for a little bit, and today he's not really having it for some reason. Kind of interesting, though. I always feel like my animals will like reflect different things, different energies I'm picking up on, and the fact that, you know, he's wanting attention, and he's really antsy. It definitely could be somebody, you know, thinking about you, interested in you, wanting to do something, wanting something to happen. And yet it's like they're just not sure if it's even going to. I mean, with that Eight of Swords and this Ace of Pentacles, they want to do something. They want to say something, and they just don't even know if they can or should. But in their daily life, they've got the Fool. This is a fresh start. This is a new beginning. This is cleared karma. This is somebody, you know, wanting to take a leap, wanting to take a chance. I'm drawn to this white rose here. It's almost as if this is somebody who'd be willing to, you know, offer friendship and start there and see what can happen if they're not sure if you're interested in something more serious, because I feel like they just want to be around you. They want to talk to you. And it's sitting here right next to a tower, and there's tower on both sides, which is kind of interesting. We'll see clarifiers, but in some cases could be somebody releasing some karmic things that have been standing in the way between the two of you, maybe a third party or another situation, so that they are free to move towards you. But we'll get there when we get there. But this Fool is facing right towards you. I feel like this is somebody who wants to see where this can go. They want to see what can happen. Let's get the clarifier for that. Spirit, why do we have the Fool? Why do we have the Fool here in the daily life for the person connected to or coming towards Virgo? Okay, moon on the bottom of the deck. Pisces energy could be significant. There could be all sorts of feelings and emotions, even some confusion with this person who could be thinking about you like crazy, but for some reason there is some quiet. It's like, I just feel like there's a lot going on that the two of you aren't talking about. We've got the Fool clarified by the Five of Pentacles. Taurus energy could be significant. And with this moon here, with this energy of somebody just really in their feels, but kind of maybe keeping things themselves, with this Five of Pentacles, it could be somebody that is missing you, longing for you, feels maybe on the outside, feels maybe unwanted, unwelcome, unsure. And yet this Fool is so positive. It's so lighthearted. But I know I've been in this situation where I'm dealing with, you know, somebody that I have feelings for, and we're not talking and we're not communicating. And yet, you know, and I know it's like, I know I deserve somebody who wants to open up, somebody who wants to share. I know I deserve somebody who wants to move forward. And yet my heart just keeps leaping, you know, towards that person, even though I'm feeling like out in the cold with this Five of Pentacles energy. That could be exactly what's going on. Like, there could be some frustration, some confusion. They could not even know, you know, if you're interested. And yet their heart just keeps moving towards you. In your heart space, you've got the Three of Pentacles. Capricorn energy could be significant, but I feel like there's aspects of this person and this connection that you really do enjoy, because this is something that you want to put time and energy into, someone that you want to be around, somebody that you want to see. Could be like a professional connection or friends, or, you know, similar interests, hobbies. Could be somebody you took classes with or the gym. I always feel like that with the Three of Pentacles is because this is kind of very practical energy, somebody you just want to be around. around more and more. You want to get to know. You feel like it is somebody that, you know, you could really admire, take things to the next level with, but you could be playing it cool, could be, you know, not even letting them know. You could be around them and see them all the time, or, you know, be looking at them online. And sometimes that is the case, and they might not even know how interested you are. Spirit, why do we have the Three of Pentacles in Virgo's heart space here? Knight of Swords and the Two of Pentacles. Okay, we do have a Nine of Wands on the bottom of the deck, our wounded warrior. Sagittarius energy could be significant here. But with that Nine of Wands, that is, you know, being interested in someone, wanting to move things forward, wanting to explore it, but feeling a little jaded, a little guarded, a little worn out, you know, maybe because of things that you've been through in the past. And yet I feel like the interest is not dimmed. We've got the Knight of Swords and the Two of Pentacles clarifying this Three of Pentacles. Aquarius energy, Capricorn could be significant, but Virgo, I feel like you can't get this person off your mind. Maybe you're talking, maybe you're not. Maybe the two of you have opened up, maybe you haven't. I mean, with the High Priestess on your side and the Moon on their side, maybe you haven't, you know, really just said what needs to be said here. And yet I feel like you can't stop thinking about them. With the Knight of Swords, your mind might just rush to them at the littlest thing. And there's a part of you that just wants to take a chance, just wants to go for it. And, you know, stop overthinking, stop worrying about what can happen, and just do something, say something, send a message. With the Two of Pentacles, you're also kind of wanting to be practical, wanting to be smart about things, might have a lot on your plate, things that you're managing, things that you're dealing with. The Two of Pentacles is somebody that has, you know, the water behind them, the waves. So it's almost like, and they're trying to balance those pentacles in the traditional tarot. It's almost like you're trying to focus on the practical things and not think too much about those feelings, but the feelings are getting stronger and stronger. And I feel like we can only keep those things in the background for so long. Ultimately, the feelings are going to come up. Your person in their heart space has the Ace of Cups, and it jumped out in reverse. And I feel like, and we'll get a clarifier on this, but I feel like on some level, it's like they almost might want to give up. Like, might almost like maybe they're trying to like fall out of love or to stop thinking about you. And yet the feelings just won't stop. There's like an outpouring of feelings, whether, you know, they really mean for it to happen or not. But I do feel like they could be, you know, they could be trying to hold back. They could even be trying to control some of the emotions that they're having. They could even be trying to, you know, play it cool here. Like, we can talk, we can be friends. That's what you want, you know, offering this white flower here, which represents friendship. And yet it's like the emotions, they just keep, it just keeps going and going. I just feel like there's something about this person where their heart just keeps traveling towards you, whether they mean to or not. And it's kind of like what I was seeing with this Five of Pentacles and the Fool. They could be feeling out in the cold or confused or not even knowing. And yet it's like their heart just, I don't know, it's like their heart chases you even if they're not chasing you. Like, they can't stop thinking about you. And there's a part of them that wants to give up. And yet at the same time, it's almost like they can't let go. It's interesting. And I don't even know if I've ever gotten the Ace of Cups in reverse. Very rarely, because I'm looking at reflecting, because I always look at the cards in the camera. And I feel like it's almost like somebody trying to let go of the cup, like trying to drop it and release it. And it's like stuck in their hand. Like, they're here, they are just putting their, I didn't even notice the way the thumb kind of goes around here. It's like, I'm trying to let this go, but I can't let it go. And the emotions just keep coming. So I know this is a lot for a general reading. This feels very personal, but it's Gemini season, and I'm just getting a ton of information coming through in these past few readings, so I just have to share what's coming through. Spirit, why do we have the Ace of Cups in reverse in the heart space for this person? Yeah, it's right here. We got the Ace of Wands. Like, Virgo, the attraction to you is undeniable. I mean, they're so interested. Whether they're trying to feel it or not, they just can't stop. We've got the Magician on the bottom of the deck, and I'm not saying it is a negative thing. Sometimes love is just like that. You don't really pick who you have feelings for. Sometimes it's not practical. Sometimes you don't know how it's going to work out. Sometimes there's long distance. Sometimes there's complications, third parties, jobs. There's all these things. It's a crazy world we live in. There's always so many things going on, but your heart has a way of just doing what it wants to do. And sometimes, you know, I know with me, sometimes I just feel like my heart is just running up ahead and dragging the rest of me along. And I just have to go with it because my heart is going to do what it's going to do. And I feel like I'm feeling that energy here. The Magician, Aries and Gemini for me as a reader, it's here on the bottom of the deck. And for me, the bottom of the deck energies are what somebody could be thinking and feeling, maybe hasn't fully acted on yet. But this is this person having a realization that they're going to have to take some initiative. They're going to have to take matters in their own hands. They're going to have to do something if they want something to happen. It seems like they couldn't stop thinking about you even if they tried. And they're getting to the point where it's like, well, I got to do something. But we've got three aces here. We got the Ace of Wands. We got the Ace of Pentacles. We've got this Ace of Cups in reverse, which just feels like somebody who just can't seem to let go, no matter what the situation is. And I feel like regardless of whatever has happened, even if there has been some sort of ending, and once again, it'll be different for each of you, this person wants to talk to you. They want to see you. They're interested in you. They're drawn to you. They're attracted to you. I always get in a love reading with the Ace of Wands, like a lot of chemistry, a lot of heat. Like this person, you could just like light them up. And once again, you know, this is all in their heart space. This might not be planned and they might not even know what to do with it, but they just can't deny it. They just can't deny the way they feel. In your intentions, you've got the Strength card. And I'm very curious about this, because there's something you could be wanting to work up your courage about. Aries, Leos, and Sagittarius for this Ace of Wands. Leo specifically for the Strength card. But there could be something that you are thinking about, wanting to do, wanting to say, a step that you're wanting to take. And you could be, you know, working up your strength, working up your courage, working up your confidence. In some cases, this can be trying to hold back. It can almost be like you're also having all these feelings, but for some reason, you're not sure if you should or could act on it. And so it's like you're trying to hold back what you're feeling, but it's like trying, you know, to tame a lion, which ultimately is, you know, the what's happening here in the Strength card. You learn to listen to your heart and have the confidence to follow it, but not necessarily let it like carry you away, to kind of balance your heart and your head, your emotions and your wisdom and intelligence, and make a decision from the heart and have the confidence to follow it through. But, you know, it's also doing something that, you know, that just feels right. So let's see what this Strength card is all about. What is going on with Virgo with this Strength card? What is going on with Virgo? What is it that they're trying to find the strength to do or say here when it comes to these intentions? Two of Swords. You're wanting to make a decision, but you're definitely torn between that head and heart. And I was really drawn to that with this Strength card. Like not wanting to let your emotions like get carried away, but also, you know, knowing that there's things that you're feeling and things that you need to do, and, you know, listening to your heart could be really key here. You've got the King of Wands on the bottom of the deck, strong Sagittarius. Aries and Leo could be significant, but I feel like there's like you're wanting to do or say something, could even be trying to find the confidence. I saw the Devil right behind there. Capricorn could be significant. It's here with the King of Wands. So once again, could be a lot of chemistry, a lot of attraction. You could even be thinking about somebody almost a little obsessively with that Devil energy. I feel like you're keeping it, you know, in check, like you're taming it a little bit, or at least trying to do that, because there's something about being smart and logical that is, you know, is making it hard for you to decide your next step. The Two of Swords really is when it's time to make a heart over head decision, and you're up in your head and you're trying to be smart and you're trying to be logical. Your heart and your head might not be agreeing, and you get stuck in a little bit of a stalemate because you don't know what to do. But the Strength card is a major arcana. It is very positive. And I think intuitively in your heart, I mean, you've got the High Priestess here. Your intuition is on point. You know what it is that you truly want to do. And I feel like you're going to listen to your heart and take that step. Your person has the Temperance, and Sagittarius energy again could be significant, but it feels to me like this is somebody who is trying to be patient, trying to be understanding, trying to trust that the universe will balance things out, bring things together when the time is right. But I do feel like they're struggling with this energy just a little bit, because we've got the Ace of Wands and the Fool, which aren't particularly patient energies. You know, these are energies of like, let's go, let's start something. But it feels like, you know, they do have some sort of understanding that things have a way of, you know, working out in the right time and the right way. I do feel like this is somebody whose heart is open to you. I feel like this is somebody who wants to explore this, but they could be waiting for some sort of sign. They could be waiting for a sign from you. They could be waiting and thinking about you much more than you know, but kind of taking their time a little bit. Let's go ahead and see. I don't feel like that taking their time is exactly what they want to do, but they also, I feel like you mean a lot to them. Okay. And we have the Four of Swords. Yeah, that is definitely another energy of somebody being a little bit quiet, maybe a little bit patient, but I feel like they're thinking about you like crazy. With that Four of Swords, it's somebody who has been through something painful. Maybe, you know, it has been difficult for them to weigh, or, you know, if they have been holding back what they're feeling and what they're wanting to talk about, I feel like maybe it has been hard. This could be somebody who's thinking about you, dreaming about you with this energy, the Four of Swords and the Temperance, but it is somebody who's taken a little time, a little pause, maybe even being quiet while they decide, you know, what to do next, what to say next. So, this is where it gets interesting, because your potential outcome for both of you, there is a Tower. And for both of you, there's a beautiful Pentacles energy of something moving forward and going to the next level. But I feel like there could be a little bit of a shakeup, and we'll see what that's all about before some really positive, stable energy comes in. But you've got the Four of Cups, the Tower, and the Knight of Coins. Cancer energy, Aries, Scorpio for me, strong Taurus for this Knight of Coins. With this Four of Cups, you might not really be happy with things as they are. What's going on currently? Maybe, you know, if you are just friends, or if somebody's playing it cool with this Three of Pentacles, or if things have been light, you know, you're not really happy with that. I feel like you would like more. You would like this Ace of Cups, which is interesting because this Ace of Cups is in their heart space, but they're definitely struggling to, you know, express that or act on it. And it's the same Ace of Cups here that the universe is wanting to offer you. Maybe this person wanting to offer you, but I don't even know if you realize it's there, or if you realize that you have this opportunity, because as somebody who's looking at what is, a little bit guarded and not able to see what could be coming towards them. You've also got a Tower and a Knight of Coins. That Tower can be some sort of breakup, can be a shakeup, can be, you know, something happening to cause you to see things completely differently. But the main thing that is happening in the Tower is a clearing of old karmic things that no longer serve. And in this particular Tower, two people are growing closer after a shakeup, after a challenge. I mean, maybe something just really shifted and it's beginning to get your attention, but it's connected here to the Knight of Coins. And so I feel like, you know, maybe you've gone through some sort of change or awakening, maybe this person, maybe both of you. We got the Tower on both sides, but it's causing someone to come forward, somebody to come in, somebody coming towards you. Could be you taking a step as well, but somebody come towards you who's been on their way for quite some time. Now, if it's somebody completely new and some of you are looking for that, there's all the aces over here on this person's side. Could be somebody completely new after you release something that just didn't, you know, was never quite right. But whether it's something new or this exact person, and you know who it is, you know who's on your mind, they have been coming towards you. Whether you know each other or not, they have been coming towards you. They have been thinking about you. They have been hoping to see you. They have been. And, you know, this Knight of Pentacles can be a slow mover, but it is the knight that crosses the finish line. This Knight of Pentacles is somebody coming forward who is looking for a Ten of Pentacles. That's what's showing up here in this person's energy. They are looking for something more serious, something more, you know, long-term, and maybe even a, you know, a shakeup or some sort of difficulty is causing the two of you to realize, you know, wait, we want this to work. We want this to happen with the Knight of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles. But before I get your clarifiers and see what it's really all about, I'll show you your person's cards. So we've got a Tower, an Ace of Swords, and a Ten of Pentacles. In a very literal sense, somebody could be going through a breakup of a karmic situation or a release of something that just wasn't right for them because they can't stop thinking about you and they're hoping that the two of you could have something together. Obviously, that's very literal. Not going to be the situation for everyone, but that could absolutely be that. But with the Tower, there is something that they're going through, something that is changing, maybe shaking up their whole world. But the Tower is always, always a breakdown of things that just no longer serve, releasing things that just were never, you know, in alignment with your center. And after the Tower comes a Star, an awakening to everything you are. And it's like after some sort of shakeup, somebody is having some major clarity here. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, specifically Virgo energy for this Ten of Pentacles. I feel like it's like there's a realization and a desire to talk, a desire to communicate. They can't get you off their mind. They want to take a step forward, but a step towards seeing if this can really go someplace with the Ten of Pentacles. So let's go ahead and see what this energy is all about. Spirit, why do we have the Four of Cups here for Virgo? Oh my goodness. Why do we have the Tower? Oh, wow. Okay. This is interesting energy. And why do we have the Knight of Coins? Why do we have the Tower for this person? Why do we have the Ace of Swords? Why do we have the Ace of Swords? Why do we have the Ten of Pentacles? Why do we have the Ten of Pentacles? And here is that Knight of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck showing up with your person's energy. Taurus energy, once again, could be significant, but this is somebody who is thinking about you. And I have to say, I feel like you're thinking about them as well. I think in a sense, the two of you have always been moving towards one another. And it's just a matter of, you know, crossing whatever has slowed this down and, you know, crossing any kind of distance or difference and just taking those steps to make it happen. Somebody could have some, you know, big plans for something they want to say or do. Clarifying the Four of Cups, you have the Tower jump out in reverse. So it's very interesting. Now, there could be something that the universe is wanting to clear out that maybe you've been holding on to a little bit too tight, that even though it's not something you're happy with, something you want, maybe there's something to do with your comfort zone and security, but the universe is shaking that up. I feel like there's somebody that, you know, through this change, through this shift, it's a wake-up call because it's getting you to open your heart and realize the potential of this connection. Somebody is there for you. And I feel like it's you getting closer to someone through a shift or through a change. Clarifying this Tower, we have the King of Pentacles. Whatever this release of whatever it was, you know, from the past that just isn't right anymore is waking you up to everything that you are. Strong Virgo energy, Capricorn and Taurus can be significant as well. But I feel like, you know, there's something that is causing you to give deep thought to this connection and to make a decision for what you want to do, what you want to say, what steps you want to take. You got the Knight of Coins clarified by the Six of Swords. Aquarius energy could be significant. You could be deciding to take some sort of step forward. Your energy, you know, the way it's facing towards this with this King of Pentacles, it's like it feels like you think, you know, it could be your energy thinking about somebody, or it could be somebody who feels like they're really a match and you releasing something that doesn't serve is bringing in this person that really is a match for you. But with the Knight of Coins, you could be taking your time, because with the Six of Swords, you don't want any stress. You don't want any conflict. You want to put the past in the past. You don't want to overthink. You want things to be smooth. And I feel like you've had enough of the drama and all of that. And you just want to move forward at a steady, you know, solid pace in a positive and peaceful direction. So I feel like you could be having some sort of big wake-up call about what it is you want to do or say. But I feel like you could be taking your time, because I think you faced enough drama in your life and you don't want to stir up a bunch. Your person has the Tower clarified by the Fool energy. Somebody literally could be going through a breakup and, you know, becoming single so that they can take a big step, or finalizing a divorce, or releasing a karmic situation, a relationship. Obviously not the case for every single person, but with the Tower and the Fool, it's like breakup, now single, you know, in a very literal sense. Of course, these cards are very metaphorical. They're very spiritual. And somebody, whatever the case is having some sort of major wake-up call. Something that just isn't meant to be a part of their world is being released right now. And maybe it has been difficult, but look at this. Now they just feel light. They feel light and free and ready to take that step with the Fool. A step, you know, it feels like right towards you. We've got the Ace of Swords clarified by the Nine of Swords. Gemini energy could be significant. Can't get you off their mind. It's stressing them out a little bit. They could be tossing and turning, trying to decide what to do. Do I say something? Do I not? And yet we've got this Ten of Pentacles clarified by the King of Swords. Strong Gemini energy again. Libra and Aquarius as well. It feels like, yeah, maybe this person has been tossing and turning with the Nine of Swords. Maybe they have even been going through some big shifts and changes in their life. But it's like now they're feeling more free than ever. And it's like all they can think about is you. And with this King of Swords, this is somebody who is very crystal clear with this Ten of Pentacles, that you're the person they want to take things to the next level with. You're the person they want to have their experiences with. They feel like this could be something that is really worth exploring. They can't get you off their mind. And with the King of Swords, I feel like they're, you know, they're going to have to do something. And because the King of Swords, a lot of honesty, a lot of integrity, a lot of clarity. It can be communication. It can be somebody taking initiative. But it seems like this is somebody who is feeling pretty sure, more sure than ever about you. And they know, you know, they know that some sort of leap of faith needs to be taken. And they want to take that leap. So that is a message I have for you. I do hope something in here spoke to everyone who is guided to this reading. If you like the message, please put a like on it. If you haven't subscribed, I would love if you would. If you'd like a personal reading or to join me on Patreon, just check the description box of this video. The links are right there. I share bonus content all month on Patreon. Love you guys, and I will talk to you soon.